False teaching, error, heresy, and how God uses them. Part 6. We all stumble into error at times, so we shouldn't be so judgmental about each other. Chapter 1. We all go off into error at times. So we need to learn gentle wisdom from God. We all get it wrong sometimes, so we need wisdom from God, not our own selfish doctrines.
James 3. For we all stumble in many ways. Who among you is wise and understanding? Let him show by his good behavior his deeds in the gentleness of wisdom. But if you have bitter jealousy and selfish ambition in your heart, do not be arrogant and so lie against the truth. This wisdom is not that which comes down from above, but is earthly, natural, demonic. For where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder and every evil thing. But the wisdom from above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, reasonable, full of mercy and good fruits, unwavering, without hypocrisy. And the seed whose fruit is righteousness is sown in peace by those who make peace. Titus 3. We also were ourselves sometimes led astray in the past, be careful to engage in good deeds. These things are good and profitable for men. but avoid foolish controversies and genealogies and strife. And disputes about the law. For they are unprofitable and worthless. Have no more to do with a factious man.
Factious in the Greek, hieretikos, is one who is choosing, or who is schismatic.
After a first and second cautioning,
cautioning is admonishing, explaining. Chapter 2. We are not to be judgmental about other people. Nor always keep looking for what is wrong with them. Humility towards others should cause us to be more accepting, and less divisive. We are quick to cry heresy about what we think is false. But is that judging wrongly?
Matthew 7. Do not judge so that you will not be judged. For in the way you judge, you will be judged. And by your standard of measure, it will be measured to you. Why do you look at the speck that is in your brother's eye, but do not notice the log that is in your own eye? Or how can you say to your brother, "Let me take the speck out of your eye," and yet the log is in your own eye? You hypocrite, first take the log out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to take the speck out of your brother's eye.
Of course, we are not to be naive, especially about those who think themselves in authority. See the verses back in part 3 about how we judge them.
Romans 14. Accept the one who is weak in faith. Do not pass judgment on others' opinions. Do not regard others with contempt. Who are we to judge another? Each person must be fully convinced in their own mind about what they think is right to do. Why do you judge your brother? Why do you regard your brother with contempt? Let us not judge one another anymore. The faith which you have as your own conviction before God.
Each person is to be convinced in their own mind. Own is eidos in the Greek. One's own individual self. Everyone understands in their own unique way. So we should not insist that others must see it our way. We can let others grow and learn differently from us. See also 2 Peter 3, verse 17. Don't lose what is firm in your own eidos mind.
Romans 15. Those who are strong ought to bear the weaknesses of those without strength. And not just please themselves. We are to please our neighbour for his good, to his edification. Christ did not please himself. Accept one another just as Christ also accepted us.
See link 18, Romans 14 and 15. What is in our heart is being exposed. How much is pride and self-interest? How much is humility?
James 4. What is the source of quarrels and conflicts among you? is not the source your pleasures that wage war in your members? God is opposed to the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Submit, therefore, to God. Draw near to God, and He will draw near to you. Humble yourselves in the presence of the Lord. Do not speak against one another. First Peter 5. I exhort the elders among you to shepherd the flock of God among you, exercising oversight, not under compulsion, but voluntarily, according to the will of God. And not for sordid gain, but with eagerness. And all of you clothe yourselves with humility toward one another. For God is opposed to the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Therefore, humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God,
Link 18, Romans 14 and 15. Romans 14, verses 1 to 22. Now accept the one who is weak in faith. But not for the purpose of passing judgment on his opinions. One person has faith that he may eat all things, but he who is weak eats vegetables only. The one who eats is not to regard with contempt the one who does not eat. And the one who does not eat is not to judge the one who eats, for God has accepted him. Who are you to judge the servant of another? One person regards one day above another, another regards every day alike. Each person must be fully convinced in his own mind. He who observes the day, observes it for the Lord, and he who eats, does so for the Lord, for he gives thanks to God. And he who eats not, for the Lord he does not eat, and gives thanks to God. But you, why do you judge your brother? Or you again, why do you regard your brother with contempt? Therefore, let us not judge one another any more, but rather determine this, not to put an obstacle or a stumbling block in a brother's way. For he who in this way serves Christ is acceptable to God and approved by men. The faith which you have offers your own conviction before God. Happy is he who does not condemn himself in what he approves. Romans 15, verses 1-7. Now, we who are strong ought to bear the weaknesses of those without strength. And not just please ourselves. Each of us is to please his neighbor for his good, to his edification. For even Christ did not please himself. Now may the God who gives perseverance and encouragement grant you to be of the same mind with one another, according to Christ Jesus. So that with one accord you may with one voice glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, accept one another, just as Christ also accepted us to the glory of God.
This was False Teaching, Error, Heresy, and How God Uses Them. Part 6.